Esther here to deliver to us the word of the Lord today. So let's receive the Pastor James Hill saying amen. Unto the Lord for his goodness. Hallelujah. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord for his what? Amen. How many know the Lord has been good? Amen. And his mercy endureth forever. How many just can lift your hands and just say his mercy endureth forever? Oh, his mercy. Scripture says that the redeemer of the Lord.
Seen you love, in whom, though now you see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your soul. That scripture really challenges all of us because it talks about rejoicing when you are in heaviness, when things are going on in your life, when you're facing challenges, when you're going through a crisis, when the different forces of life are coming against us from many, many, many different directions. Scripture says that wherein ye greatly rejoice. This is the opportunity to perfect your faith and to get your faith activated and move in the direction where you can receive deliverance. And I believe that most deliverance you will find is going to be what you do in the midst of what you're going through. Amen. What you do in the middle of what you are going through. How many know that many things that we confront, many things that we have to experience, many challenges in life, many trials and hardships that we face are not going to be always easy for us to go through and come out more than a conqueror. Amen. But the scripture says that God be for us. Amen. How many know that if God is for us, amen, who shall be against us? Amen. Praise God. But the thing is that in the midst of whatever we are going through, it's important for us to remember, amen, to remember the word of God. Remember what God said. Amen. Remember the things that God has already, amen, done and put in place for us to be more than conquerors through him that loves. How many believe that we can do all things through Christ? Amen. How many believe that greater is he that is in us than he, amen, that is in the world? Amen. The scripture states this in Romans 14:17. I want you to just turn there. Amen. Romans 14:17, it mentions about the kingdom of God is not meat and drink. Amen. It's not always going to be easy. It's not going to be, amen, always the thing that's going to be gratifying and pleasing and that it's going to be easy. But scripture says the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's what?
Righteousness.
What? Peace. Joy in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. How many know the joy of the Lord is our strength?
Amen.
How many know if we have faith, amen, if we have joy to mix with that word, it's going to cause our faith to become what? Active. And it's going to cause our faith to become what? Alive. Amen. So the kingdom of God is not what? Meat and drink. But it's what? Righteousness. What? Peace. And what?
Joy.
Amen. How many know that joy is very important to your faith?
Amen.
Amen. It's your response to the word of God. Amen. When you receive the word of God with thanksgiving, that's what the scripture says, be careful for nothing, but in all things by what? Prayer and supplication. Amen. With what? Thanksgiving. Let your request be made what? Known. Amen. So God is looking for what? Thanksgiving. Amen. Amen. We know the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous avails much. Amen. But let me tell you that God is looking for that prayer, amen, to be offered up, amen, in faith. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
And the greatest expression of your faith, amen, is the joy that follows, amen, whatever you're saying. Hallelujah. You got to have that what?
Joy.
Amen. This scripture that we started with, it says that, amen, let's turn back to that scripture. It's, it was 1 Peter. Let's turn back to that scripture that we started with, 1 Peter 1. Amen. It says, wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptation, that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold, that perishes, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ, whom have not seen ye love, and whom though now ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory. Amen. Amen. That's the type of response to the word of God that will get, amen, you through those manifold temptations. It's the joy unspeakable and what? Full of glory. Amen. So in that particular passage that we started with, amen, the thing that stands out with, to me is, amen, greatly rejoice in heaviness. Amen. When you are going through heaviness, when you're going through distressful times, when you're going through sorrow, when you're going through pain, amen, realize that the key to getting through is going to be what? Greatly rejoicing. Scripture says in everything, what? Give thanks, for this is the will of God concerning us in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 How many can say amen?
Amen.
Greatly rejoice is the key. Hallelujah. Rejoice with joy unspeakable, receiving the end of your faith, the salvation of your soul. How many can say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
I want you to look at Philippians 3:3. That scripture always challenges my heart. Philippians 3:3. Amen. It describes, amen, the attitude that we must always remain in order to get results, and the attitude required for us to always, amen, come out more than conquerors, amen, through him that loves us. Okay, Philippians 3:3. Okay, I want you to read that with me. What does that say? For we are the circumcision which worship God in the Spirit and rejoice in what? Christ Jesus, and have what? No confidence in the flesh. Amen. Those things really stand out to me. Amen. We, the circumcision, we what? Worship God in what? The Spirit. Hallelujah. Amen. That's the key to victory. Worshiping God in the what? Spirit. It's not by might nor by our power, but the scripture says, but it's by my what?
Spirit.
Amen. We can do all things through who? Christ. That what? Strengthen us. Amen. Hallelujah. I found that that was the key. Amen. When I was going through my challenge about a month or so ago, amen, I had to, amen, force myself to be glad. Bible said that all of those that what? Seek thee, what? Rejoice. It's not always going to come, amen, easy. And many times we don't really, really, amen, praise God, persist in what? Breaking through the flesh and what? Moving in the realm where our faith will really become alive. I don't believe that our faith really becomes alive until we begin to what? Amen. Agree with the word and begin to what? Get excited. Amen. About what God has what? Provided and has already what? Blessed us with. Amen. Now, many times we try to get victory. We try to win our battles. Amen. Without the word. But the scripture says the weapons of our warfare is not what? Carnal. But they are what? Mighty through God. God has provided a way for us to what? Get through every trial, every hardship, amen, hallelujah, every unfavorable circumstance, God has already provided a way out, amen. Is God, amen, the Bible says that the weapons of our warfare are not cut off, but they are what? Mighty. God's weapon will always work, and the scripture says that we, the circumcision, amen, we worship the Lord in the what? In the Spirit. Amen. How many know its power? Amen. It's not by might. mind, but it's by what? The Spirit of God. Hey, hallelujah. It's the Spirit that what breaks the yoke. Amen. The burden that, amen, that needs to be removed is going to be removed because of what? The yoke. Amen. Praise God. So when we begin to move in the Spirit, when we begin to rejoice, amen, when we begin to praise the Lord for what? The end result of our what? Salvation. Amen. The power of God is what? Released. Amen. The anointing begins to what? Praise God. Kick in. Amen. And things begin to happen in the Spirit. How many can say amen? We worship the Lord in the what? In the Spirit. Amen. And we what? Rejoice. You know, sometimes I believe that we don't get excited enough. Hallelujah. How can God, you know, we keep God's hands what? Tied. Amen. Because we want what? Amen. We don't get excited about what God has provided. Amen. Turn to Philemon 1:6. It mentions about the, amen, the effectual of the effectiveness of our communication. Amen. Praise God. Is going to be demonstrated. Amen. In other words, the effectiveness of our faith is going to be what? Demonstrated as we acknowledge. Amen. As we acknowledge. Amen. All of the things that God has already what? Provided and made accessible to us. Just somebody just read that for me. Philippians 1:6. Philemon. Amen.
That the communication of thy faith may become effectual by the acknowledging of every good thing which is in you in Christ Jesus.
All right, now this is when your faith really begins to get activated. When you begin to acknowledge the what? The communication of your faith has to be what? Acknowledged. In other words, you got to what? You got to express. You got to what? Say. Amen. Praise God. And claim and lay hold to all of the things that God has already what? Provided us through who? Christ Jesus. Amen. Praise God. So the scripture, amen, is very clear that in order for us to, amen, really begin to enter into that realm where the blessings of God are going to be released. Amen. We have to get into the realm of the Spirit, and we got to worship the Lord of the Spirit, and we got to rejoice in Jesus Christ, and we got to what? Have no confidence in the flesh, and our confidence got to be in what? The Word of God. We got to what? Praise God. Say what God says about the problem or the need or the trial or the challenge that we are going through. How many know that the Word of God will not return, amen, void of power? Amen. How many know, hallelujah, that God's covenant, he will never what? Break, neither what? Alter the Word of God and alter the things that have what? Come out of his mouth. How many can say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
How many know the Word of God will always work? His word to perform it. Amen. If we would just agree with the word, if we would just say what God says, amen, God is what? Faithful. Amen. Praise God. Amen. To fulfill the word of God that you speak. Amen. Praise God in faith. Hallelujah. Amen. I want you to just turn to Mark 11:23. Praise God. The scripture says that whosoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed. Amen. Praise God. That shows that the Word of God has to be declared. The Word of God has to be what? Spoken. And we got to come into agreement with the Word of God. Amen. The scripture says that whosoever shall say to this what? Mountain. How many know that there's deliverance in your mouth? Amen. The Bible says the mouth of the just shall what? Deliver them. Amen. Mark 11:23 says this. Somebody read that for me.
Whosoever should say unto the mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he
says, yes. Yes, he shall have.
He shall have whatsoever he
says. All right, so it's important for you to what? Say something. Amen. When you're going through trials, it's important for you to what? Say what God says about what? Your situation. Amen. Amen. Whosoever shall what? Say to this. How many got a mountain this morning? Amen. Amen. What are you going to say to your mountain? Be thou what? Removed. How many going to say, be thou removed? Or it's easy to just say, be thou removed, but you got to what? Believe in your what? Heart. Amen. That it what? Shall come to pass. And the Bible says that if what? If you believe in your heart and say it with your mouth and what? Believe it in your heart. Amen. It shall what? It shall come to pass. Hallelujah. Amen. But I believe that also in order to make that word you say, amen, active and to give it life and amen power, you got to add some what? Rejoicing with that. How many can say amen? That's the faith part. Hallelujah. You got to say it with your mouth and believe it in your heart, and you got to what? Act as if that word is what? Amen. Is true. And the most convincing evidence that you will ever demonstrate would be what? Rejoicing and praising God and calling the things that be not as what? Though they are. How many can say amen?
Amen.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
How many can say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
How many can say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
How many can say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Woo, glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. I'm going to give you the story. Amen. I know my time is getting. Amen. Jonah 2. Amen. They try to cut me back. Amen. But in Jonah 2, I want to just read just a little bit of that. This is the story alright, somebody help me find Jonah 2:9, Jonah 2:4. The story of Jonah is the prayer that Jonah prayed out of a fish's belly. Hallelujah. And the scripture says that in verse 4, amen, Jonah, his prayer out of the fish's belly. Somebody read verse 4.
Then I said, I am cast out of thy sight.
Okay, I got it, okay. Then Jonah prayed unto the Lord his God out of his fish's belly, out of the fish's, and said, I cried by reason of my what? Affliction unto the what? Lord, and he what? Heard me. Out of the belly of hell cried I, and thou heardest my voice. For thou hast cast me into the deep, in the midst of the seas, and the floods come past me about. All the billows of thy waves passed over me. Now this was Jonah's dilemma. This was Jonah's, amen, test, trial. Then said I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again towards thy holy temple. Hallelujah. That was the words that what came out of Jonah's mouth. Amen. That's what he said. I will look again, although I'm cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again towards thy holy temple. Amen. Verse 7, when my soul was faint within me, I remember the Lord, and my prayer came in unto thee, into thy holy temple. They that observe, now this was Jonah, they that observe lying vanities would do what? Forsake their own mercy. But I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of what?
Thanksgiving.
I will pay that I have vowed. Salvation is of the Lord. Now that's what Jonah said. Amen. Salvation is of the what? Lord. And the Bible says, and the Lord spake unto the fish, and it vomited out Jonah upon the dry land. Amen. So Jonah's victory was in his what? Mouth. Amen. He's the one that made the declaration. Amen. I'm cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again towards thy holy temple. When my soul fainted with within me, I remember the Lord, and my prayer came into thee, into thine temple. Amen. Then he began to make a declaration. They that observe what? Lying vanity. Yes. Hallelujah. Forsake thine own mercy. Amen. How many don't want to forsake that your own mercy this morning? Amen. Praise God. Just keep your mouth closed and don't come into agreement with God's word. And don't praise him and don't magnify him. That's the way you can what? Forsake God's mercy. But Jonah said, I will what? Sacrifice unto thee with a voice of what? Thanksgiving. I will pay that I have vowed. Salvation is of what? The Lord. How many can say this morning, regardless of what you're going through, regardless of how hard those trials might be that you have been facing, that my salvation is of the Lord. And I'm going to look to the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. If the Lord be for me, who can be against me? Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. No weapon formed against me shall prosper.
Praise the Lord. For the Bible said, in the midst of their, amen, hallelujah, their suffering down in prison, they begin to what?
Sing praises unto the Lord. How many can say hallelujah? How many know it's good to be able to sing praises to the Lord at midnight? How many ever sing praises at midnight? That's the hardest time to sing praises. With the hallelujah, when the winds are blowing, amen, the trouble is coming in from every angle. Amen, when the devil said, praise God. Amen, I got you now. Amen, when you begin to lift your voice and say, praise the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endures forever. Hey, hallelujah. When you begin to praise the Lord, amen, praise God, things begin to happen. Amen, the enemy's power over your life is broken. Hey, hey, hallelujah. The power of God begins to, amen, begin to release, be released. Hey, hallelujah. Praise God. How many can say praise the Lord? How many can say praise the Lord? How many can say praise the Lord? Glory. Stand on your feet. Hallelujah. But when Peter, when Paul and Silas began to sing praises, the Bible says the foundation of the jail was what? Prison was relieved. It was what? It was shaken. Glory. They came out shaking, wondering if all the prisoners had been, praise God, hallelujah, released. But Paul said, we are all here. Hey, we are all here. Amen, praise God, hallelujah. They praise the Lord until victory came and every man's bands were loose. They got the victory because of that what? Praise. Singing those praises, hallelujah. So I just want to say, hallelujah, that if you want the victory, hallelujah, amen, praise God, you stand fast in the liberty wherewith Christ, stick with the word, hallelujah. The Bible says, hold fast to your confession of faith. Hold fast to your confession of faith without wavering, because God is faithful that what? Promise. Okay, lift your hands and say, God is faithful and promised. If I delight myself in him, he'll give me what? The desires. Amen. He says, fear not, O ye land, rejoice and be glad, and God will do great things. How many can say not? God said, fear not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will what? Strengthen thee. I will help thee. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. How many know we have God's word for it? And we know that no weapon formed against us will prosper. How many can say amen? Lift your hands and say, no weapon formed against me. Lift your voice and say, no weapon formed against me. Say it again, no weapon formed against me. Say it again, no weapon formed against me. No weapon formed against me. I'm going to praise the Lord. I'm going to rejoice and be glad. You to just search your heart today, and I want you to just search your heart, and I want you to, amen, praise God, and see if there is, amen, a real, genuine spirit of thanksgiving, a spirit of rejoicing, hallelujah, that's missing in your life today. Hey, God wants us to get back to rejoicing him and praising him before the answer comes. Praising him in the midst of our hardships and our ups and downs. He wants us to praise him in the midst of our battle. Scripture says, don't wait until the battle is over. Amen. Praise that song. Say, amen. Shout now. Hey, God. will fight the battle if we would just what? Praise him. If we would just delight in him. If we would just rejoice in him. If we would just hallelujah, hallelujah, call the things that be not as though they are. Amen. How many want God to restore the spirit of rejoicing? Scripture says rejoice the evermore. Bible says rejoice greatly. Hallelujah. Bible says hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within us. I want every person, I hear another sound of my voice. I want you to just lift your heart, lift your hands right now. Say, Lord, restore the spirit of rejoicing. Hey. Lord, restore the spirit of rejoicing. In the midst of what I'm going through, hey, just say, but in the midst of what I'm facing, help me to rejoice in the midst of this. Help me to rejoice. Say it again. Help me to rejoice. Because my victory is in rejoicing. Help me to be glad. In the midst of what I'm praised, I'm facing and confronted. Because my victory, hey, my victory is in my rejoicing. Come on, lift your hands up. Lord, I thank you.